Video solution to NCERT exercise question, class 10 mathematics, exercise 9.1. This is question number 15, an interesting question. This chapter is applications of trigonometry. It's a heights and distances question. A straight highway leads to the foot of a tower. A man standing at the top of a tower observes a car at an angle of depression of 30 degrees. So from the top of a tower, a man observes a car and the angle of depression thus formed is 30 degrees. The car is approaching the foot of the tower with a uniform speed. 6 seconds later, the angle of depression of the car is found to be 60 degrees. 6 seconds later, from where he was observing from point one, the car is at point two, which is closer to the tower, and right now the angle of depression is 60 degrees. What we need to find out is the time taken by the car to reach the foot of the tower from the second point. Let's get started by having a schematic. AB is a tower. Let the height of this tower be h meters. From point A is where this person is observing the car. The first point of observation is at D. The angle of depression right now is 30 degrees. The car is approaching the tower. In 6 seconds, it reaches point C. At point C, the angle of depression from A works out to 60 degrees. Now look at it. AE and BD are parallel lines. AD is a transversal that cuts through it, which means alternate interior angles, which is angle AED, this angle, will be the same as angle ADB, which means that angle ADB is also going to be equal to 30 degrees. This is what we would have usually said, that angle of depression is equal to angle of elevation. Extending the same logic, AE and BD are still parallel lines. AC is a transversal that cuts through it. Now, this angle EAC and angle ACB are two alternate interior angles, or the angle of depression at A will be the same as the angle of elevation at C. So angle ACB is equal to 60 degrees. What is the approach we are going to be taking? Let's get started. It's a four-step process. What we'll do is, let's quickly do a schematic of this as a right triangle. This is a tower AB. This is point D. This is point C, right? So this is what we have. We will express the height of the tower H in terms of this distance BC, right, from the first, second point of observation. Next, what we'll do is, we'll express this height of the tower in terms of DB, right, that's point number two. Because the height of the tower is common to both these things, we'll equate those two and we'll get the relationship between DC and CB. Then we'll compute the time taken to cover CB, now that we know that it takes 6 seconds to cover DC, right? That's the approach we're going to be taking. Let's start with step number one. We're going to express the height of the tower H in terms of BC, which we assigned a variable which is equal to A units. So we're going to be looking at triangle ABC, which is a right triangle. In triangle ABC, angle ACB is the angle of elevation, which is equal to 60 degrees. To this angle, AB is the opposite side and BC is the adjacent side. Now, the trigonometric ratio that combines the opposite side and the adjacent side is tan. So, we're going to be working with tan of this angle ACB, which is tan 60 degrees. Tan 60 degrees is equal to the opposite side, which is H, divided by the adjacent side, which is equal to A. Tan 60 is root 3. So, root 3 is equal to H by A, or we can rewrite H to be equal to root 3A. We said we'll express H in terms of A. We have done that as step 1. Quickly summarize it in a printed form, going with tan 60, which is angle ACB, opposite side by adjacent side, which is AB by BC. AB measures H and BC measures A, so we get the value of H to be equal to A root 3. Step 2, we'll express H in terms of DB. Let's do that. H in terms of DB, DB measures nothing but A plus B. We're looking at right triangle ADB right now. In right triangle ADB, to angle ADB, AB is the opposite side and BD is the adjacent side. So basically, we're going to be again looking at trigonometric ratio tan, because tan combines the opposite and adjacent sides. So tan 30 degrees in this instance is equal to the opposite side H divided by the adjacent side BD is equal to A plus B. Tan 30, we know, is equal to 1 by root 3, which is equal to H by A plus B. Cross multiply, we get A plus B is equal to root 3 times H. So we'll express H in terms of A plus B. We're actually expressing A plus B in terms of H. Now, in the previous step, if you recall, we got the value of H to be equal to root 3A. I'm going to be substituting H as root 3A here. So we will have A plus B is equal to a root 3 into root 3A. Root 3 into root 3A is equal to 3A. So take the A to the right hand side, we'll get B is equal to 2A. So the distance DC can be now expressed in terms of A, which is equal to 2A. quickly capture it, summarize it till this point before we compute the last step, which is finding the time taken to cover CA. Right? Going to be going with tan of 30 degrees, which is opposite side AB divided by adjacent side DB. DB is equal to DC plus CB, which is B plus A. So tan 30, 1 by root 3 is opposite side H divided by adjacent side B plus A. So cross multiply it, we get A plus B is equal to root 3H. We know from the first step that H is equal to root 3A. I'm going to replace that here. So we get the value of AB is equal to 2A. Now look at it. If B is equal to 2A, to cover 2A, it has taken 6 seconds. So to cover A, how long will it take? It's going to take 3 seconds. That's the last step for us. The cover distance of 2A, which is from D to C, it took the car 6 seconds. So to cover half the distance, which is from C to B, which is A units, it's going to take 3 seconds. So car will reach the foot of the tower from the second point of observation in exactly 3 seconds.
Supercharge your math quotient. Sign up today for online CBSE math classes at online.maxtute.com. I'll repeat it. It's online.maxtute.com. And before you leave, check out the related videos and remember to subscribe to this channel.